G'day. In this video, we're going to have a look at one of Costar's greatest management tools for your workshop, the Costar Appointment Scheduler. To get started, we're going to go down into our appointment section and open up the appointment scheduler. The first thing that we're presented with here is a view of our month and the workload for each particular day. It's color-coded so that you can easily decipher at a glance what days are busy and which ones you can fit more work into. So we can see, for instance, we've got 10 appointments, 25 hours filled, and 10 hours blocked, which means that the day has been filled up to a capacity of 46%. On Thursday, we can see that we've got 5 appointments, 20 hours filled, and 15 hours blocked with 37% capacity filled. Whereas on Friday, we can see that we're at 66% capacity. So depending on which day we want to go to, we can just double click on that particular day, and it brings up the appointment scheduler for that day. Now, the appointment scheduler is essentially broken up into two sections. You've got the top section, which shows us all of the jobs that have been assigned to that particular day. And down the bottom is where we can assign those individual jobs to the bays that are required to carry out those jobs. You can also see that each particular job in the top section is color-coded, and those color codes coincide with our legend up the top here. So we can easily see the blue-colored jobs are just appointments at this stage. So in other words, the customer hasn't turned up and we haven't committed any stock. We've got our purple jobs, which are jobs that have been booked online through our appointment scheduler, and which we will cover off in another video. Thirdly, we've got our yellow jobs, or our in-progress jobs. So these are jobs that the mechanics have started, or the cars have arrived, we've committed all of the stock, and we're currently working on those jobs as we speak. And lastly, the green, which indicates that the job has been completed and is waiting for the customer to pick up the vehicle. So that's the color coding. We've also got a number of things to make this screen a little bit easier to follow. We can, for instance, click on the expand details, and that's going to show us a breakdown of each of these individual jobs, what parts are required, what services, etc. are required, and whether any of these jobs have been completed. Again, we can untick that box, and that will compress those jobs for a more readily viewable screen. We can also view or hide any already scheduled appointments so that we know which ones need to be assigned to our work grid in the bottom section of the screen. So if I hide already scheduled, I'm left then with two jobs that need to be scheduled into my grid. We've got Ron McDonald, which is blue. We can see as an appointment, and to schedule that in the grid, I can open that up to see what's required. So we can see that we need some tires in here. We also have a wheel alignment, so I'm just going to grab that job and drag it down to the appropriate time and bay. I can then extend that one job so that it blocks out the entire hour for 4 tires. From here, I can then just copy that and paste it into the appropriate position for my wheel alignment bay. Or alternatively, just drag it again from the top down into the section as required. For the second job that hasn't been assigned, the customer has rung us and told us that he's no longer available to come in today. So we need to reschedule that job to another day. And that's just as simple as clicking on the job and then choosing a day out of our calendar again. Again, we just choose a day by double clicking on it, where it then prompts us to move that highlighted appointment to the date, in which case we'll say yes, and from there we're then able to assign it to the appropriate bays as we did in the previous appointment. We can go back to the day either by clicking on the drop down and choosing the calendar, or alternatively we are able to use these buttons that take us to the previous day or the next day, respectively. We also have the ability to block out times for days as required. So in this instance, we've got a lunch time for all of our bays from 12 o'clock to 1 o'clock, and that's ongoing. Alternatively, if the mechanic is sick or on holidays for the day, we're able to do is block out that day simply by going to the appropriate day, choosing the bay that they will be missing from, and then block that time. We would block it off for the entire day so that we know what's happening and that no work can be assigned to that bay for that day. If we need to go beyond the day, then we can set the date range that it's applicable to. We say okay, and then that bay will be blocked out for those particular days. We're going to go back to today, and we've got all of the jobs there. And so in order to make new appointments, there's a number of different ways of doing it, but by far the easiest way is just to go down to the appropriate time slot and double click in the bay that's required. And from there, our appointment screen will be brought up where we're able to bring up the customer or whatever the case may be. In this instance, I'm using the Rego lookup, which finds the customer. I indicate who's looking after the job and what's got to be done. In this case, we're going to put on four tires and a wheel alignment. So we fill out the screen accordingly. And when I go back out of there, we've got the appointment already scheduled, so I'd be able to extend that down and paste it into the appropriate area. In this instance, the customer is also going to take the courtesy car, so we can paste that appointment in the courtesy car as well, so that we know it's been assigned to that customer for the period of time that it's required. When that customer arrives at our store, we can open that appointment just by double clicking on it and convert that appointment over to a repair order, which then enables us to print out a job card or alternatively assign it to a mechanic if you're using Costar Mobile, and they'll be able to use our digital inspection forms accordingly. Check out our Costar Mobile video for more information on that feature as well. We're also able to, from a day planning point of view, print that grid out, which enables us to print out a total listing of all of the jobs, parts and labour codes required for each job and each bay on that grid. Once you've got your grid sorted, a good habit to get into is to let your customers know via SMS what time they're booked in for. And it's as simple as incorporating CoStar's SMS feature. We go into our SMS appointments, where it will show all of the appointments that are due between a particular date range, and we would select all the appropriate appointments. We can then click next. We choose the appointment reminder, and that will then do a mass message out to all of the customers, letting them know their vehicle and the registration number of that vehicle, along with the time and date of their booking, and asking for them to give you a call to confirm. So when you send that SMS, you are ensuring you are maximizing the efficiency and workflow for your technicians to ensure that you're getting the most out of your equipment and resources. Using this appointment scheduler in conjunction with SMSing, Punch Clock, as well as Costar Mobile, gives you the ultimate workshop management system so that you can ensure that you're getting the most out of your technicians and most cars in and out in a timely fashion to increase your revenue. We hope you found this useful. If you have any questions, just give us a call or submit a support query through our website. To keep a track of upcoming features in Costar, make sure that you subscribe to our channel and check us out on Facebook and LinkedIn. Thanks, and we'll see you in the next video installment.